Hey guys, Ryan here at Signature Edits, and today I am beyond pumped to show you this incredible Lightroom feature. It's called Auto Masking, and it changed my life, and I think it's gonna change yours too. Let's do it. So what is auto masking and how is it going to change my life, Ryan? Well, I'm glad you asked, fine sir, madam. It's going to change your life because it is going to save you so much time when you're editing, and it is going to allow you to do things in Lightroom you had no idea you could even do before. So first, what is auto masking? If you've ever used your adjustment brush, you may have noticed this little checkbox down here, and it says auto mask. That's basically Lightroom's intelligent mode for when you are using your adjustment brushes. So let's go down here and say I'm going to draw on this path, okay? I've pressed O, and that's actually what's going to reveal where I've drawn. And as I'm drawing, I've got the auto mask feature on, and you'll see that it's naturally picking up, for the most part, the lines of contrast between this pavement and these little sidewalls. The reason it's not doing the perfect job is because the sidewalls are a pretty similar color and consistency, and auto mask is not super great all the time at detecting that. So if I go here, it should just sort of mask out this stone from the rest of the castle. And that is the basic way of using auto mask. It can be super helpful in certain situations. So for instance, if I go over to this image here, I could possibly use auto mask to make a little mask on this sky without necessarily getting on to these mountains and stones right here, okay? So that's how I would use auto mask in this situation. And it's very handy because now I can take the exposure on the sky and take it way down, for instance. Okay, that's how I would use auto mask before. And this is something that is super helpful. But what is going to blow your mind is there is an easier, better, faster, more efficient, and more effective way that will save you so much time and allow you to do things you never thought you could do before. Or if you did know you could do them before, would just take you forever, so you would never do it. Okay, so what am I talking about? Well, take a look at this. First, I'm going to zoom out on this photo. Then I'm going to take my adjustment brush and I'm going to take the size all the way up so it's gigantic, okay? Now the reason I'm doing this is because I only have to click once and the auto mask feature is automatically going to detect the area I click, this little center spot of this whole adjustment brush. And it's going to detect the color and the brightness of that particular area in the image, and it's automatically going to mask out everything that it thinks matches up with that color and that brightness. This is amazing because, as you can see, with one click, I've gone ahead and, for the most part, accurately masked out all of this background from the photo without masking out my subjects. Now, if I, for whatever reason, need to erase a little bit of the mask, I just hit Alt, and that'll toggle to the eraser, and I can just draw on his sweater where I don't actually want the mask to affect. So literally, in one click, rather than having to go through and draw manually onto this entire image, I have masked out the background from my subjects. What's so awesome about this is if I turn off O, I can now do whatever I want. I can take my exposure way down. I can take it way up. I can do all sorts of crazy things and effects. Or I can just be more subtle. I can add a little bit more focus to my subjects, maybe a little bit more clarity to the background if I want to bring out that texture there, a little bit of saturation without affecting any of the skin tones. This is amazing. So take a look at this. This is before, and this is after. All from one simple mask that takes 1 second. Let's look at another example, okay? So here we've got this photo. We're going to zoom out by selecting the 1:8 ratio, or if you have a bigger screen, you can use something else. And then I'm going to, let's say I want to darken down these mountains in the back or lighten them up, okay? I hit the auto mask and it's done a pretty good job right out of the gate. I press Alt and I can just erase from down here. And just like that, it's already gotten this whole line here is automatically masked and has done a very good job, saving me a ton of time. So now all I have to do, press O again, and I can darken them up. Bam, just like that. Or maybe I lighten them up. Whatever I feel like doing, you know? Let's take it one step further. Let's take the auto mask, make a new mask, and we're going to click these bushes. Let's say I want to bring out the blue in these bushes a lot more, okay? One click, and it didn't work so well. Why is that? Well, because the area that I clicked clearly was not a specific enough color to mask out that area of the bushes effectively. How do I fix this? Well, it's actually pretty easy. I just drag it onto another area of the bushes that hopefully has a more specific color range and matches up with the bushes, but not with all of the grass. So that is looking pretty good right there. Now I can just press Alt, erase the other parts of the image that I don't want the mask on, especially my friend here. And just like that, press O again, and let's bring the white balance down, saturation up, and we've got the bluest bushes there ever were on the planet of Mars, okay? We can do all sorts of crazy effects if we want to. Let's move on and look at some more practical applications, okay? So here's another one. Let's say that I want to just change the color of her sweater. Well, all I have to do, grab my mask, click on a part of her sweater. Oh, okay, her eyes were picked up, and this little background, I'm going to press Alt, just erase out of the background, erase off her eyes. Now we can have fun. Let's take this, and we can make it way more blue if we want to. Bring the saturation up, maybe bring the brightness up just a little bit. And just like that, we've gone from this to this. So simple, so fast, and it took no time and no effort. It's amazing. Let's keep looking, okay? So let's take this adjustment layer. Click right there, press O. Yeah, it's masked out our entire sky. So now we can get our sky back in just one click instead of having to manually paint on there one stroke at a time. Here's before. Rather, here's before and here's after. Just like that, about 2 seconds, what would normally take me 10 minutes of painting in Lightroom. Are you seeing how amazing this is? Let's take it one step further still, okay? Let's go for this van this time, okay? We've got the color of the van, we're masked out. Very easy in this case because the color is very specific to the van. Now what we can do is we can take our white balance down, we can take it up, we can maybe add some magenta in there, we can make it the most saturated blue bus you've ever seen, we can darken it, make it a navy bus, or we can even use this color function, which is really, really cool. Now in this case, because the bus is already blue, we're going to the van, not a bus, what are you doing, Ryan? We're going to have a hard time making it something like red because red is the polar opposite and it's just not going to happen. But we can make it into a green bus, let's say. So let's go for a lime green bus, the greenest bus there ever was. Fiddle with our white balance just a little bit here. And just like that, in about 2 seconds, I've gone and I've done a very complicated mask that would take a long time to paint manually. Just like that, you can make your bus green, right? All your dreams have come true. You can make your buses green from here on out. How amazing is that, okay? This one is a really crazy example that I absolutely love. Okay, take a look at this. Let's say that I love my castle, but I want to bring out some of the saturation in the trees. I want them to be more bright. I want them to feel, you know, lovely and whimsical, okay? Well, I could try and bring the saturation up, but the problem is it's going to affect the castle, the people, everything in the image, not just the greens. So let's take this back. Let's reset our vibrance and our saturation, and let's do our trick here. Let's go to 1/8. Let's click somewhere in the green. Press our O keys so that we're going to see what we're doing, just like that. Now let's say that the first mask didn't work out so well. I can just drag this to a different point, drag it around on the green, and Lightroom is going to continue auto-masking and saying, oh, okay, colors in this area, colors in this area. So let's say right around here seems to be pretty good. I don't want to get the castle in the mask, right? So that has saved me a ton of time. If I want to, I can then make my brush a little smaller and just go over these areas that are really easy to paint over. Bam. So in 2 seconds, I've done a very complicated mask. Now, I can take my saturation way up, take my vibrance, take my saturation way up, I can take my exposure up a little bit. If I want to get some more green in those plants, I could even add green in the white balance. I could warm things up if I want it to be more of a warm feel. And we have gone from here. From here to here. Isn't that incredible? With very, very minimal being affected in the castle, the people, everything looks natural. And that is the hardest thing to do when you're editing a photo, is to get it to look amazing, but also get it to look like it wasn't really edited. Like, that's the goal, is that your edits are kind of seamless. They just blend in without really standing out. So let's do one more, and I'm just going to show you another thing you can do here. We can grab our brush, make it huge again. And let's say that I want to just maximize the dynamic range in this image. Well, this is another handy feature here. We can click this highlight, and Lightroom is automatically Hopefully, not in this case, it looks like. Going to, it should. Oh, you know why it's not working? Because I switched to adjustment brush B and that doesn't have auto mask enabled. So there you go. If it's not working for you, that might be why. Now click on this area of highlight. There we go. Now it's automatically masked out these individual highlights that are kind of being blown out, to be honest. And we're going to do one more maybe on her pants here where it's bright. Perfect. So now we've done a super complicated mask in 2 seconds. Press O again. Let's make this a little bigger. And I can very slightly maybe bring down my highlights. Now obviously some of these were lost in the photo, so there's not a ton of room. But just like that, we've gone from here to here. Something that would be super complicated to do if you're doing this manually. Like, let's say I was trying to do it manually, right? I would have to make my brush a lot smaller. And then I'm going to be like, okay, turn off auto mask. Here we go, just going to paint, and it's going to be great. And oh man, that's literally impossible, right? I'd have to make it super small, and maybe turn my feather up and my flow down so that I could just slowly paint on here. And even my slow painting with the most detail I can do is still not going to be as good as if I were to delete this, turn on my auto mask, zoom out here, make my brush nice and big, and just select that one point. Hello? Oh, it's because my flow is all the way down. There we go. And just select that one point. And bam, it's done. Just like that. Now, I can come in and I can finesse it from there. That's one thing that manually you can do is just add that extra little bit of accuracy and detail. But you can see how much time this saves you. You know, like let's say we want to adjust her jacket. So let's just click here. And bam, in one click, we've got the jacket. Do a second click and Lightroom is actually going to add to that mask. So we're not just going after this color range now, we're also going after this color range. Perfect, so press O again and let's brighten this jacket up. Let's take some color, let's try and make this jacket red. Isn't that nice? The best red navy jacket that you've ever seen in your life. So I hope this was helpful for you. Honestly, this is a game changer for me because what I normally wouldn't have time to do, I would never have time to go through and just paint out her jacket here if I was editing a wedding or an engagement session, that sort of thing. But when it's so fast that all I have to do is one click and done, I can actually do that. I can take my photos to the next level. So that is it for our tutorial today. This is the Lightroom trick that has changed my life and rocked my world, and I believe it is going to do the same for you. I can't wait to hear how you use it and how much it helps you. Please, if it did, leave me a comment below. I want to hear from you. And make sure to hit that like button. Don't forget to subscribe for more great stuff, and I will see you in the next video. Stay awesome.